Well, the American Cancer Association estimates more than 3 million people will be diagnosed with skin cancer this year alone.
It's one of the most common types of cancer and also one of the most preventable. Joining us in studio to talk more about how we can prevent skin cancer, we have Dr. Swati Kannan, a dermatologist with UC San Diego Health. So thank you for being here.
Thank you for having me.
Okay, we're talking about skin cancer, and obviously with 3 million cases that are supposed to be diagnosed this year alone, it's pretty common, but I feel like not a lot of people talk about skin cancer.
I know, and that's why we have May, which is Skin Cancer Awareness Month, to really encourage patients to look at their own skin and to go see a board-certified dermatologist for their annual skin check.
What are some of the best ways that we can prevent skin cancer? We can't wear long sleeve clothing all of the time or, you know, cover our face with a mask. So what are some of the ways that you would tell the people out there to prevent this?
Well, sun protective methods are still number one for prevention of skin cancer. So that includes obviously wearing sunscreen greater than SPF greater than 30 or 50, wearing wide-brimmed hats, wearing long sleeves if possible with UPF, and also seeking sun protective behaviors like seeking shade, avoiding outside when it's really hot, like between the hours of 10 a.m. and 4 p.m. And those are usually the best ways of preventing skin cancer that you can do at home.
Mm-hmm. I feel like there's a lot of myths associated with this. I know that I've heard from a lot of people, they don't want to put sunblock on because they're like, but I want to tan. I'm like, it doesn't prevent you from tanning, correct?
Sunscreen does not prevent you from tanning. But we always say a tan is a sign of sun damage. There is no such thing as a healthy tan. And so we do not encourage anyone tanning or going to tanning beds.
You know, let's talk about some of the treatments that have been going on. A lot of people hear about lasering, you know, and try to deal with this. What about modern technology? What can you tell us?
Sure, so laser resurfacing is one of the best ways to prevent skin cancer. And there was actually a study in 2023 by a group in Harvard that took a group of patients who already had a history of skin cancer. One group got laser resurfacing once a year and the other group did not. The group that did had a 48% reduction in their skin cancer risk. And if they did get a new skin cancer, there was a delay in when that new skin cancer appeared. So lots of really great benefits now to laser resurfacing.
What should we be looking out for? I mean, I know that I feel like I've heard if, like, you see a mole that starts to grow, what are we looking out for before we really need to take this seriously?
Yes, so there's three main types of skin cancer. So you have your basal cell, which usually presents as a pearly bump or a sore that just doesn't heal. And that's the most common kind of skin cancer. Then we have our squamous cell carcinoma, which is the second most type of skin cancer, and that presents as like a red, scaly patch that again just doesn't heal. And then for melanomas, which are the deadliest forms of skin cancers, that presents as an atypical mole that's asymmetric, the borders are fuzzy, the colors are, you know, they look weird, not homogeneous, diameters greater than 6 millimeters, or that they're changing. So that's the ABCDE criteria for melanoma.
Mm-hmm. What about here in San Diego? I mean, a lot of people come here, they want to lay out the beach or lay out by the pool. How many patients have you seen with skin cancer?
Oh my gosh, I'm a skin cancer surgeon. So I treat about 20 patients a day with skin cancers, ranging in ages from 18 years of age all the way to 100. So it's incredibly prevalent in San Diego because we don't really have a winter season. It's just summer and sun all year round.
And so, you're saying that I guess the way that you get skin cancer is when you're not protecting your skin from the sun.
Correct. Sun exposure plays like one of the most major roles in skin cancer risk. And genetics play a role as well, but sun exposure is really plays the most role.
Okay. And just from what I heard from you, you're saying to see your dermatologist once a year.
Correct.
Okay.
Especially if you're in that high risk population where you get a lot of UV exposure or if you're very fair skinned.
Okay. Absolutely. Okay, doctor, thank you so much for being here.
Thank you.
For you at home, we do have a link to the doctor's website at fox5sandiego.com. Just go to there and hit the Seen On tab, and you'll find more skincare tips and make sure you stay protected.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.